this is Above Average Magazine, and we're here at the NAACP New Jersey with Justine Simmons. She's being honored tonight. How does it feel to be honored by the NAACP?
Well, I was very surprised, very honored, happy, happy to be here also, and just happy to be in a company with Dionne Warwick, and I'm really very, very happy and thankful. Well, they said that my award that I received was honorable woman, and I guess God really gave me that position because as a young child I didn't even want children, and now I love children so much, and everybody's getting big, of course, at home, and I'm just happy to be, you know, have that award. Hi, this is Justine Simmons, and I'm with Above Average Magazine, and I'm at the NAACP Awards, and I'm getting an award today. Thank you.
What made you get involved with the NAACP?
That's a good question. What made me get involved? I think I was involved most of my life since I was a young child. My parents always was involved, and it was just a way of life for us. As I became an adult, I got my kids involved. I used to carry them around with me. That was our social outlet. And we would take them out, whether it was to different affairs, they would be right there with me. So it's just a way of life. That's the fun part of it. The sad part of it is the injustice that's out there that still exists today that we need to fight. We need to be visible. We need to show them that we care, and that people will fight for what's right.
How does it feel being a female president of the NAACP Gloucester County chapter?
Well, I think in the role as a leadership that I've always had all my life, you know, when you see different things that need to be done, you just step up to the plate, you get your team behind you, and there you are.
How would you like to get young people involved in NAACP in Gloucester County?
You know, that's been one of our challenges. Sometimes you ask the average teenager and you ask them what NAACP stands for, they have no idea. They really don't know the history. So that is one of the challenges that we decided to do about a year ago. We've resurrected our youth council that hasn't been resurrected in over 10 years. We've gotten involved with the colleges. We're going to be doing an endowment with Gloucester County College, something that we'll live on forever and ever. And, you know, these are some of the things that we're trying to do to get involved with the youth, and so that we can pass that torch on to them.
What issues are you having in Gloucester County currently?
The issues in Gloucester County, I think it's basically the same issues that we have throughout the world. Education, economic, jobs. You know, there's still racial profiling. There's still discrimination. It's just that it's done very subtly. So these are some of the things that we have to recognize, and sometimes people do, and they don't even realize it. Loretta Winters, the president of Gloucester County NAACP, here with Above Average Magazine. Thank you.
Hi, this is Latoya from Above Average Magazine, and we're here with the vice president of Dream Girls. Could you tell us what your name is?
Sure, I'm Lady Tracy Aikens.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
So do you mind telling us about Dream Girls? What is Dream Girls?
Well, the Dream Girls Gathering is that conference that ranges from girls from 8 to 18, and our goal is to empower them with self-esteem, knowing that they have other people that have been where they are, and that they can be whatever they desire to be, teaching them how to dream again, giving them hope, and letting them know it's okay to be a virtuous young lady no matter what the age, no matter what you've gone through, that God still desires to use them, and that they still have worth, and that they're not forgotten about.
So I understand you guys had your first conference. How was that?
It was awesome. We had 130 girls from ages 8 to 18 come out in Bridgeton. We were at Cumberland County College for 3 days. And we did dream sessions. We did empowerment sessions. We talked about AIDS and awareness of their bodies. We had a dance camp with an awesome instructor from Florida, LaAsia Walton. Nietzsche from Nietzsche TV. And Carrie Hedden, mm-hmm. She's also a public speaker. They were some of our facilitators. and the girls had a wonderful time. And then we cap it off with a concert, which is the Dream Girls concert. And we had Crystal Akins and Michelle Bonilla and Karima Kibble. And they left so excited and so empowered. It was worth every bit of sweat that we went through.
Okay, so where's Dream Girls going next?
Well, we're going worldwide. We're actually getting ready to go to Cleveland. We're scheduled for Charlotte. We're scheduled for Atlanta and Louisiana. So those are the first couple of stops that we're making. And we're looking to come to a city right near you. So this is Lady Akins here at the NAACP State Conference and Above Average Magazine.